Hey guys, I'm Chris from Focusrite Novation, and today I'm at Nevada Music in Portsmouth. As you can see, we've got a fantastic display of all Focusrite and Novation products here. At Nevada Music, we've got some fantastic experts on hand that will always be happy to talk to you about the various different features that you find on our products. And they're always here on display for you to be able to come and have a play as well. Now, throughout this video, I'm going to explain the Focusrite range of audio interfaces that we currently produce. And it's an interesting question that you get asked a lot, but people are often asking, what do I need to be able to record? Well, firstly, an audio interface is probably the most important aspect for any computer-based recording setup. The audio interface allows you to plug in high-quality audio connections and convert that signal into a language that computer speaks directly into your DAW software. So if you want to capture the best possible quality, it's always really advisable to get yourself an audio interface. As you can see from the Focusrite display that we have here, we have quite a range of different interfaces, and it can often be a little bit confusing to know which is the right one that you need. I would say here, with our Focusrite interfaces, we have something that would suit pretty much every type of user. On the left-hand side here, you'll see we've got our red Scarlett interfaces, and on the right-hand side, we have our black Saffire interfaces. The Scarlett interfaces will connect to your computer using a USB connection. So if you're working on a PC or a Mac computer and have a free USB socket, we have a USB interface that will allow you to plug in directly into your computer via USB microphones and guitar or line level signals. Now, if you have a connection such as a Thunderbolt connection or a Firewire connection, the Saffires will allow you to plug into that type of connection. If you have yourself a Thunderbolt connection on your computer with a little adapter like this, which is a Firewire to Thunderbolt adapter cable, the Saffires will plug into that connection and give you exactly the same experience as if you were plugged directly into a dedicated Firewire port. Now, there's a number of advantages to be able to use this, because with Thunderbolt or Firewire, generally you're probably not going to be using that many Thunderbolt or Firewire devices. And this means that the audio has its own direct pipeline into and out of the computer. If you're working with a USB interface, it may well be that you've got a number of different USB peripherals, for example, QWERTY keyboards, mice, controller keyboards or synths and this sort of thing. And that's all sharing the same way into the computer. That said, with the USB 2 connection type that we have nowadays, the audio interfaces that are USB based are perfectly fine to transfer that data. But if you have got Thunderbolt or Firewire, it's often a nice thing to be able to have that dedicated way in and way out for your audio signal. Now let's consider the actual interfaces themselves. And here we have the brand new Scarlett Solo. And this is the entry point really for anybody who wants to get recording into the computer in an inexpensive way. The Scarlett Solo gives you a microphone preamp and then a jack input in which you could plug a guitar, or we have a switch here which allows you to choose a line level signal, for example something from a synthesizer, that sort of thing. On the back we have a pair of outputs as well. So this is ideal if you're only going to be really recording yourself with maybe a single microphone or just a guitar or mono synth, something like that. The Scarlett Solo is the kind of entry point, if you like, to the Scarlett range. After the Scarlett Solo, we have the incredibly popular Scarlett 2i2. Now, the key difference here is you'll see that we have a different type of connection on the front. This is known as a combi connector. And in this connection, I can plug an XLR or 3-pin microphone connection into this socket. Or if you see in the center here, we also have a hole in which I could plug in a jack socket. So this means that on the Scarlett 2i2, I could actually plug in two different microphones and record them separately into my computer. Or alternatively, a guitar into one and a microphone into the other. Or, of course, two guitars. So this unit, the Scarlett 2i2, increases the possibility of your recording capabilities, i.e. more instruments, more microphones, that sort of thing. The next system that we have is the Scarlett 2i4. And the 2i4, again, has the same combination microphone preamp connections and jack connections. But this time, as its name suggests, the 2i4, we get four outputs. Now, having additional outputs can be a very useful thing. What we're able to do with this is we could connect a second set of speakers if we were so minded, or I could also set up, for example, if I'm working with a drummer in a live environment, that drummer may need to have a click track. I can organize the click track to come out of the headphone socket and switch it over to outputs 3 and 4 here. That means that if I feed the click track to outputs 3 and 4, the click will come out of the headphones, but not come out of the main outputs on the back of the unit. There'd be nothing worse if you're playing live with a band and all of a sudden you hear the click track through the PA system. So this sort of unit can be really useful in that way. Also, if you're a digital DJ, you may want to have a pre-listen or cue channel set up in your DJ software. Once again, I can set up that pre-listen channel to send its signal out of outputs 3 and 4, plug my headphones in here, and then we have our cue channel. So this is the Scarlett 2i4, and following that, we have the 6i6. Now the 6i6 increases the amount of inputs that we have and the outputs. So again, we have the same two microphone preamp inputs, which we can also plug jack sockets in. But on the back, we've also included a second pair of line inputs. We've got our four analog outputs here as well, and we have MIDI in and out. I should have mentioned actually, the Scarlett 2i4 also has MIDI in and out. Now, it's called the 6i6, but if we count up the analog inputs, you might say, well, we've only got four analog inputs and four analog outputs. That's because over on this side, we have a digital input as well. This is a stereo input and therefore is two separate channels. So if you have anything that outputs a digital signal, the 6i6 is a perfect combination to that. We can plug our digital signal into the SPDIF digital input, and we still have our four analog inputs to be able to use. Following on from the 6i6, we have the 18i8. Now this is stepping up quite a bit in terms of the amount of inputs. You can see already we have four microphone preamp inputs on the front here. And if I spin it round, we have another four line inputs. That's a total of 8 analog inputs directly on the unit. In terms of outputs, we have outputs 1 and 2 here, but we can also treat these two headphone outputs as independent sets of outputs. So I have outputs 1 and 2 on the back of the box. This could be set to outputs 3 and 4, and this could be set to outputs 5 and 6. So you have a really versatile way of being able to patch and route all the audio signals to the relevant places. Now, on this unit, we've also included an optical input. This allows me to plug in a further 8 channels of audio into the unit, which can then pass on that information to your computer and your DAW software. The optical input is perfectly served by a unit that we have down at the bottom of our display here, the Octapre. The Octapre is a system that gives you 8 microphone preamps, and it has on there an ADAT output. So if I plug 8 microphones into this unit, take the ADAT output, connect it to my 18i8, that will then give me 16 analog channels directly into my computer. So this is a really nice system if you're going to start recording in a bit more of a serious way. Perhaps you want a close mic drums, or if you're going to record a larger ensemble, the 18i8 plus the Octapre will give you 16 input channels. It's called the 18i8, and once again we have a stereo SPDIF digital connection to make that up to the 18 inputs and the 8 outputs. So those are the Scarletts. There is another Scarlett, which is the 18i20. And the 18i20 is a single unit rack device and gives you 8 microphone preamps built in to the unit. Alongside that, we also have another ADAT connection. This means that we can get 16 channels of microphone preamp into your DAW software. It's called the 18i20, and on the box we have 10 outputs. And again, if we use something like the Focusrite Octopre Dynamic, which also has an ADAT input, we can use the outputs given to us on the Octopre Dynamic to give us a total output count of 20. So you can see this is really stepping up in terms of the connectivity that we have. Now, one of the really nice features about the Focusrite interfaces is that we have incredibly nice microphone preamps. And a great thing about the whole range is that whether you're buying the Focusrite Scarlett Solo to get that great sound, or if you're buying an 18i20 or an 18i8, you will be getting the same microphone preamp technology. Obviously, as you step up through the range, you're getting more microphone preamps. So that's the Scarlett, the USB connecting interfaces, and now we'll have a think about the Saffire range. The Saffire range starts at the Pro 14. The Pro 14, again, has the same mic pres as we found on the Scarlett's, and on the back here we have a pair of line inputs, MIDI in and out, and we have four analog outputs. Here we have our stereo digital connections as well, so stereo in and stereo out from digital, and this now will connect via Firewire. So as I mentioned earlier, if you have the Thunderbolt to Firewire connection, you can plug this into a Thunderbolt port on your computer, or if you have a straightforward Firewire connection, you could plug it directly into that. So from the Pro 14, we have the Pro 24, and the advantage for the Pro 24 is now you can see that we have even more outputs. We have MIDI in and out again, and our stereo SP diff connection. So once again, we're starting to increase the track count that we're able to work with. Underneath the Pro 24 here is the Pro 24 DSP. This is an interesting one because on the Pro 24 DSP, we have a digital signal processing chip, which will allow you to use some DSP-based audio effects, such as reverb, compression, and EQ. Another feature on the Pro 24 DSP is the VRM technology that's also based in this box. VRM stands for Virtual Reference Monitoring. And Virtual Reference Monitoring is the ability to listen to your mixes on headphones, but in different listening environments. This means you have a choice of different speaker types and different rooms that you can listen to your mixed music on. One of the first things that most people do when they've created a mix down of their track is go and listen to it in a different environment. This will help you isolate any issues that you might have with the original mix. The VRM technology will let you do just that on a set of headphones. Another nice feature on the Pro 24 DSP is the pair of headphone outputs. And again, these are independent. So I can set up a separate mix to come out of this set of headphones, and then another mix to come out of this set of headphones. Following on from the Pro 24 DSP, we have the new Pro 26. And the Pro 26 gives you a pair of instrument or line inputs on the front, but if I spin it round, you'll see that we have our four microphone preamps. The first two are just straightforward XLR connections, but inputs 3 and 4 are the combination connections that you see across the Scarlett and Saffire range. We also have an additional pair of line inputs, and we have 6 outputs. This, again, is increasing the amount of things that I can record at one time, and so is great if I'm going to explore recording larger ensembles or recording drum kits and that sort of thing. We also have an optical in, so the Pro 26 is an ideal companion to the Octopre set of microphone preamps as well. Now, we've mentioned the Octopres, and they're here at the bottom of our display system. We have two Octopre models, the Octopre and the Octopre Dynamic Mark II. The Octopre is a straightforward set of 8 microphone preamps. The Octopre Dynamic also gives you a compressor on each channel. This is great for being able to control and manage the dynamics of the things that you're recording. And it's a VCA-based compressor, and is a very easy to use system. and we have just basically an amount of compression we can apply to the signal. If you're going to start recording your drum kits with close miking and that sort of thing, the Octopre Dynamic is ideal for this because we have the compressor per channel and we have an extended headroom to allow for loud dynamics from your drum hits and that sort of thing. Finally, on our display, we have at the very bottom the Liquid Saffire 56. This is the flagship audio interface from Focusrite in the Saffire range, and this boasts up to 24 channels of audio recording, analog audio recording. That means we have 8 microphone preamps on the unit itself, but this time we have 2 ADAT connections. This would allow me to connect a further 16 microphone channels directly into the Liquid Saffire 56. So that's a huge amount of audio recording and would suffice most needs for even the largest recording studios. Another really nice feature on the Liquid Saffire 56 are the inputs 1 and 2, or microphone channels 1 and 2. These are liquid mic pres, and that means that we use software emulation to emulate 10 exceptionally nice vintage microphone preamps that you would pay a heck of a lot of money for. The Liquid Saffire 56 is brilliant for producers that are looking for different flavors for their recording. So you can choose a different microphone preamp setup on your Liquid Saffire 56. So when you buy a Focusrite audio interface, you can be sure that you're going to get exceptionally high quality microphone preamps and a great quality audio interface that will get superb sound recorded directly into your DAW software. But in the box with all of the audio interfaces, we also provide you with the software that you need to get going. With all of the audio interfaces, we have Ableton Live Lite, which is a superb DAW software. We also include a suite of plug-in effects, and these include reverb, compressor, EQ, and a gate. These are great effects if you want to apply, for example, EQ to your signal in your DAW, and they sound fantastic. That sounded so cheesy. Shall I just carry on and we chop that bit out, chop my cheesiness out?
Okay, yeah.
Cool. So alongside the DAW, Ableton Live Lite, and the plug-in suite of effects, there's also over a gigabyte's worth of audio samples, including drum loops and lots and lots of different types of audio samples. And also, there will be a copy of the virtual version of the Novation Base Station plugin. So when you buy your audio interface from Focusrite, not only are you getting the audio interface, but you're getting all of the software requirements as well to get going recording. So that was the range of the Focusrite audio interfaces, the Saffires and the Scarlets, which we have on display here at Nevada. But alongside that, we also do iOS-based audio interfaces, including the iTrack Solo. iTrack Solo is the perfect companion to an iPad. So if you're doing your audio recording these days on an iPad, iTrack Solo is a great way of getting a Focusrite mic preamp and an instrument input directly into your iOS software. Alongside working with the iPad, the iTrack Solo is perfectly at home on your PC or your Mac computer as well, as are all of the audio interfaces that we're dealing with. So the iTrack Solo is a great way of being able to get good quality audio in and out of your iPad. Now, alongside the iTrack Solo, we also produce this. This is the iTrack Dock. Now, this is also a fantastic audio interface for your iPad, but this suits Lightning iPads perfectly because we have a docking station with all of our controls on the top panel, so it's really nice and easy to access them. And if you're working on an iPad Mini, an iPad Air, or an iPad Retina, you can essentially move the Lightning connection so that you can plug any sized iPad directly into the iTrack dock. If I just spin the box around, we can actually see an image of the back panel as well. And we can see here that we have dedicated microphone inputs and dedicated line inputs directly into the iPad. We also have a dedicated instrument input, which would allow me to plug in an electric guitar or a bass guitar. Another really cool feature on the iTrack dock is the USB MIDI connection. This means I can plug any of my controller keyboards directly into the iTrack dock, and that will pass the MIDI information through to my iOS app. So this is the iTrack dock, a very neat and elegant solution for any Lightning iPad user. Now, we've also got another brand new product, which is the iTrack Pocket. The iTrack Pocket is our first iPhone product and is designed to be a fantastic stereo microphone and guitar input, which will then link directly into your iPhone. The iTrack Pocket is a great way of being able to capture high quality sound directly onto your iPhone. We've also developed an app called Impact. It's free to download and works brilliantly with the iTrack Pocket. The Impact app will give you things like guitar amplifier simulators. So I can plug my guitar in here and then I can use amplifier simulations of various very popular models of guitar amp. Also, using the Impact app, I can record my video from the front-facing camera or the rear-facing camera and it upload it immediately to YouTube for people to view. So the iTrack Pocket is a fantastic way of capturing high-quality audio directly into your iPhone. And if you use the fantastic Focusrite Impact app, it's a brilliant way of getting high quality audio and video recording at the same time and being able to publish that to your YouTube channel in a matter of minutes. So there we have it, a good look at the whole range of Focusrite audio interfaces. If you're interested in getting hold of a high quality audio interface, do come down and speak to the guys at Nevada and talk about the Focusrite products. Here we've got a lot of experts that are always happy to help you make the right decision, but also we have all of the audio interfaces available for you to come and take a good look at. Thanks very much.